The Honor Magic 6 Pro has the potential to shake up the status quo of the high-end smartphone market, bringing the fight to Samsung's top-end Galaxy S24 Ultra. That's not just true in terms of hardware, with the Magic 6 Pro sporting not only more advanced screen tech, but a camera setup with a range of firsts that could potentially steal the Samsung flagship Zoom crown. There's also a premium design, all-day battery life, and solid top-end performance on offer, ticking plenty of boxes for what a flagship smartphone in 2024 could offer. Honor's big weakness continues to be MagicOS, however. There's nothing intrinsically wrong with it, but the iOS inspiration is more obvious now than ever, and its GenAI features aren't quite as advanced as first hoped either. It's also more expensive than the £949 Honor Magic 5 Pro at £1,099, but while nobody appreciates a price hike, I kind of get it. The Magic 6 Pro is wholly more capable than its predecessor was, especially in the camera department, and that price still comes in at £150 less than the 256GB Galaxy S24 Ultra. The question is the hardware good enough to pair with Honor's heavily stylized approach to Android? You might be surprised by the answer. The Honor Magic 6 Pro boasts a distinctive design with a glass or vegan leather option. The green variant, featuring a textured finish, exudes both grip and aesthetics. The Star Wheel camera island adds a cohesive touch. Although it sports the same 6.8-inch screen as the Galaxy S24 Ultra, this thing feels way smaller in the hands thanks to its curved body. Weighing 225 grams and measuring 8.9 millimeters thick, the phone feels robust, offering a comfortable grip. Notable features include a dual camera cutout, which might just look like a camera cutout, but is actually used for Face ID level security, IP68 resistance, and Honor's nano crystal shield for enhanced durability. Honor's Magic 6 Pro boasts a stunning 6.8-inch AMOLED display with a sharp 1280 by 2800 resolution. The screen is feature-rich, offering 120Hz refresh rate with LTPO 3.0 tech, enabling power-saving drops to just 1Hz. The screen reaches an impressive 5,000 nits when watching HDR content, making it the brightest on the market and ensuring readability even in bright sunlight. The customizable screen, loaded with more tech than the S24 Ultra, complements various activities, from social media scrolling to immersive Netflix binging. Stereo speakers further enhance the audio experience, though they're not a substitute for good quality headphones. The Honor Magic 6 Pro boasts an exceptional camera setup, challenging the Galaxy S24 Ultra's zoom prowess. The 50-megapixel main camera impresses with an industry-first HDR sensor and variable aperture, delivering detailed, vibrant shots with natural bokeh. The 180-megapixel 2.5x periscope lens outshines the competition with a wide aperture and pixel binning tech that allows it to compete with the S24 Ultra's 5x periscope lens with more realistic colors. The 50-megapixel ultrawide excels in various conditions, while the 50-megapixel selfie camera, featuring autofocus and an f2.0 aperture, provides a noteworthy option for selfies and video calls. Honor's Magic 6 Pro impresses with robust performance specs, featuring the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3, 12GB of RAM, and 512GB of UFS 4.0 storage, a notable upgrade from competitors like the Galaxy S24. As expected from the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3, the Magic 6 Pro delivers outstanding performance in daily use, offering smooth scrolling, rapid app loading, and quick response times. Benchmark tests confirm its prowess, handling graphics-intensive games like Call of Duty Mobile with absolute ease. While not a dedicated gaming phone, its power ensures satisfying gameplay for casual gamers. Honor's Magic 6 Pro runs MagicOS 8 on Android 14, showcasing inspiration from iOS in its design. Despite a familiar split notification center and quick settings, MagicOS 8 introduces iOS-like features on the lock screen and includes a standby mode, creating a mixed impression. That's largely because it lacks the polish of iOS and omits basic Android features, revealing UI inconsistencies. Noteworthy additions include the GenAI powered Magic Portal and Magic LM. While Magic Portal offers limited utility, Magic LM promises on-device assistance for various tasks, though its effectiveness remains untested because it isn't currently available on my test unit. Compared to Samsung's Galaxy AI tools, the Magic 6 Pro's features may require further refinement. The Honor Magic 6 Pro boasts a unique 5,600 mAh silicon carbon battery, offering exceptional everyday performance. Its silicon composition enhances environmental sustainability and allows for a smaller, denser battery, ensuring functionality in cold environments. Chip-level real-time voltage detection optimizes discharge and charge processes for longevity. With optional features enabled, the phone typically retains 45 to 50% battery after a 16-hour day, providing 6 to 7 hours of screen on time over the course of 2 days. The device supports 80-watt Honor Supercharge and 66-watt wireless supercharge, delivering rapid charging. However, a charging brick and wireless charger are separate purchases. Using a third-party 100-watt USB-C charger I had laying around, I found it regained 50% charge in 18 minutes and a full charge in 45 minutes. The Honor Magic 6 Pro competes favorably with Samsung's Galaxy S24 Ultra, delivering impressive camera performance, a sleek curved design, and top-tier screen tech with a peak brightness of 5,000 nits. Powered by the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 chipset, it ensures excellent performance and features all-day battery life, all at a more affordable price than Samsung's flagship. However, its MagicOS 8 software could benefit from quality of life improvements, deviating from its iOS-inspired design. Notably, it falls short in long-term support with 4 OS upgrades and 5 years of security patches, compared to the extended 7 years offered by the Samsung Galaxy S24 Ultra. Additionally, the Magic Pool AI tech presents some initial limitations. So that's the Honor Magic 6 Pro. What do you think of this year's flagship? Let me know your thoughts in the comments and don't forget to hit subscribe.